How would you like to live to 100 years old? And how would you like to reach that ripe old age and be healthy, be happy, and be connected to this amazing community around you and feel that you're leaving this legacy to your family, to your community that is powerful and meaningful? I think that really should be the aim of all of our lives, to really have this legacy, this impact we make in our communities, and have this higher purpose we serve. Because if you want to live long and thrive in old age and have good health and good relationships, the most important thing is to have a higher purpose that guides you. And this purpose can be religious, it can be spiritual, it can be philosophical, it can be moral, it can be, you know, political or social. It's all these different ways we can be guided by higher purposes which we use to serve people around us. And when we have that purpose and we've defined it and we've refined who we are, why we're here, and what we can offer to other people in terms of serving them, it really awakens something in us, this possibility that we were born to create with. But we get detracted from it by just making a living and being educated in the normal system that wants us to comply with a certain cultural standards and whatnot. And we need a little bit of all that, but we also need this creative leap of faith that comes from believing in something strongly, this higher purpose, and not just believing in it, but living it, like sharing it with our community, living for it, teaching it, developing what it is inside of us. And I think from that, we can create a life that we dream into existence, that we use our creative imagination to craft this life that, you know, of all these possibilities, the life that we were born to live, where we have that deep spiritual connection to ourselves, to others, to this wider community that we exist in relationship to in this life. So if you want to live to 100 and thrive to 100, the biggest thing you can do is build community and build a sense of belonging and build it around some core values and this higher purpose that you serve. Because there's this paradox of this helper's high, that we actually feel more happy and alive when we help other people, when we're in connection and communion with other people. So seeking that out is how you live to 100. It's actually as important, if not more important, than what you eat and how you exercise and how you relax and how deep you sleep and that kind of stuff. It's just as important, if not more, because it's the connective glue between everything we do, is this tribe that we exist in, this tribe of connection and belonging. So if you want to live to 100, pursue a higher purpose, uncover it, do the contemplation of who you are and why you're here and what you can offer with your abilities and natural talents and what you love to do, and connect that to the world around you, to a problem or a challenge or something that inspires you in the world around you, and then live for a higher purpose and serve a higher purpose, and build a community that allows you to thrive and helps other people thrive as well. So I think that is how you live to 100. I'd love to hear your thoughts on what makes you thrive, what makes you feel alive, and what makes you feel this vital force inside of you. I'd love to hear them in the comments below. All right, thanks for listening.